tanks delaying new COVID-19 drugs. 2 years into this pandemic and several research groups are still working on COVID-19 drugs. That's good news because we may have something versus newer variants. However, these new advancements are facing big challenges, which may lead to better drugs being delayed. After 2 years of rapid research, we have gathered several vaccines and treatments for COVID-19. Despite emerging variants, the drugs still work in preventing serious symptoms. But they will need to be updated soon before a dangerous variant appears. Remember Delta? It was likely the most deadly of the variants we've identified, sending hospital cases and deaths off the charts. We're quite lucky that Omicron replaced it in circulation or will be facing the collapse of the healthcare system. According to Nature, there are three big problems in upcoming COVID-19 therapies. They must be dealt with ASAP or a really effective product may not reach the market in time. This is because SARS-CoV-2 is endemic mutating and the brewing of another deadly variant may be happening under our noses. So what are these issues? The first is the diminishing pool of trial participants. We used to have large pools, especially in hard-hit nations. Thanks to massive vaccination campaigns, most people aren't eligible for new trials because of their vaccines. The typical setting for vaccine trials involves those who haven't been vaccinated. Of course, investigators may tweak the requirements like participants who only receive a single dose. But that pool is quickly shrinking too. In Brazil, the deaths were once at 3,000 per day, but have dropped since to fewer than 200 a day. That's good for the population but problematic for clinical trials. One way to beat the situation is to move trials to territories with low vaccination rates, such as South Africa and Pakistan. The second is the new type of hesitancy. Vaccine hesitancy was one of the reasons why vaccination efforts at the start of the pandemic were slow. Not many wanted to try a new vaccine, especially with a new virus involved. Conspiracies further ignited the problem, so no surprise that death rates rose daily as science and hesitancy wrestled against each other. Today, people have figured out their safe regimen against COVID-19, like remdesivir only and remdesivir plus dexamethasone. This makes newer combinations difficult to market among participants. And finally, the complexity of statistical calculations. With many treatments available, it's now difficult to statistically prove if a new drug is difficult or not. Investigators could go for more participants, but recruiting is a problem. Fewer participants, slower clinical trials, and dicier statistics are making it difficult to find the next generation COVID-19 therapy. What do you think investigators should do? Should they stop and instead wait till another variant claim lives? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.